What connects mutant telepaths like Professor Xavier and Emma Frost? Magic users like Doctor Strange and Magic. Gods like Thor and Loki. Reality warpers like Legion. And cosmic beings like the Phoenix, all together. The answer is the astral plane. Welcome to Everdream, and today we're going on a psychedelic journey beyond this earth to the astral plane of Marvel Comics. Please click that subscribe button if these kinds of videos are your thing. Turn on that notification bell to get notified of future videos as they release. Sit back, relax, take a load off, and let's get underway. The astral plane or astral dimension is a dimension or realm, if you prefer, that exists in the same space as our dimension, but it is made up entirely of ectoplasm. And what ectoplasm is sort of like the atoms of the astral plane. The astral plane is devoid of substance or mass, so as atoms make up the building blocks of the physical world, ectoplasm makes up the astral plane. Now, if you've never watched Ghostbusters before, then you may not know that ectoplasm is also the stuff ghosts are said to be made out of, which is fitting because another name for the astral plane is the spirit world. Now, the astral plane first made its debut in Marvel Comics in Strange Tales, issue 110, which is also the very first comic that Doctor Strange made his own appearance in Marvel Comics, which just goes to show you how important this dimension is to the character. Since then, it has been featured in many other Marvel titles like the New Mutants and X-Men, but it is mostly predominant in Doctor Strange stories. In the comics, Doctor Strange frequently travels to the astral plane through one of the only means humans can access this dimension, and that is through the art of astral projection. Astral projection is the practice where one detaches their consciousness or spirit out of their physical body. Sorcerers are able to do this through an advanced form of meditation or just through magic. They can also use magical means to bring other people with them from the physical world into the astral plane. But magic users aren't the only ones able to astral project, as telepaths like Charles Xavier and Emma Frost can do the exact same thing. They do this through a more advanced form of telepathy as opposed to magic or meditation. It does take some training for telepaths to access this dimension, but it usually is nowhere near the amount of training sorcerers need. And once the spirit is separate from the body and the astral planes are accessed, the laws of the physical world become irrelevant and all things become possible. Once in the astral plane, one becomes invisible and intangible to the physical world because, well, you're not in the physical world. You're in another dimension that occupies mostly the same space as the physical world. Because of this, telepaths and magic users can use the astral planes to move about and spy on events that happen in the physical world largely unseen. They can also fly and move at superhuman speeds, unbound by both gravity and time. And all this is just barely scratching the surface of what's possible here. It is said that thoughts shape reality. In the astral plane, this is literally the case. Telepaths who possess the greatest power over the mind can conjure just about anything they can imagine in this dimension, limited only by their will and imagination. They can grow in size, change the environment to be whatever they want, create weapons and armor, project psychic energy bolts, and so much more. Reality bends to their will in this realm, and they call the shots. On the other hand, non-telepaths appear to have a lesser degree of power in this realm. We see sorcerers like Doctor Strange perform feats like flying and size-shifting his astral form, but rarely does he, if ever, do some of the more impressive feats that telepaths can pull off in this dimension, like conjuring objects and manipulating the environment. It appears only telepaths can do these kinds of things. But magic users are far from defenseless, as they can still use magic while in the astral planes. There are others who can also access the astral realm that aren't strictly telepaths or sorcerers, such as clairvoyants, people who can see the future, and gods. Bast, the patron god of Wakanda and the Black Panthers, for instance, prefers to live in this realm as opposed to his home realm. Other gods also occasionally float about in the spirit world from time to time, like Thor, the god of thunder, who cannot just astral project but also manipulate the flow of time within the dimension through magic in order to achieve foresight. Now, as stated previously, this dimension exists outside the laws of time, so time as we know it is fluid in this dimension. Thor has been seen fast-forwarding the flow of time and looking into not just one future, but multiple possible futures. The Ancient One also does some time-bending in the movie Doctor Strange, where she slows down time considerably enough to observe lightning take shape. Now, the link between the spirit world, time, and foresight isn't just exclusive to magic users, as telepaths like Xavier and Psylocke have also been known to have premonitions of possible futures, and it's only logical to assume it's because of their connection to the spirit realm. To back this up, as stated previously, characters who possess powers to see the future but aren't telepaths like Irene Adler, aka Destiny, can also access the astral planes, further implying a connection between foresight and this dimension. Also to note, telepaths can also actively control the flow of time in this dimension, just like magic users, as we see in Legion, where a moment in time in the physical world is stretched for hours in the astral plane by a telepath. Yet, despite all the power adepts, telepaths, and even gods gain through this dimension, they are not invincible, as one can still be harmed or even killed. If an astral form is still tethered by your body to the physical world, as is mostly the case, the damage done to your spirit will be reflected to your body. So, if for instance, you got stabbed while in astral form, your physical form will receive the same damage, and if significant damage is done to your astral form, your physical body will die. The creatures capable of inflicting these kinds of damage are other psychic entities, like astral sorcerers or telepaths, obviously. But there are also other strange and bizarre creatures in the astral plane that are in fact native to it, as it's their home realm. And while most of them behave more like animals or non-sentient creatures, in that they are only hostile when looking for food, FYI, they feed on psychic energy, which is you, there are others that are a bit more malevolent. Take the Mumudrai, for example, which are a type of psychic parasite that can steal a person's identity and twist it to become the antithesis of what that person is. They are very dangerous and have frequently been a thorn in Professor Xavier's side. And speaking of which, we also have the Shadow King, a ruthless psychic demon that is trapped in the astral plane and usually gets into conflicts with not just Prof X, but the New Mutants, Psylocke, and David Haller, aka Legion. Other creatures such as actual demons are also capable of seeing and damaging an astral form, like Ghost Rider, even if they aren't in the astral plane themselves. You are also just as vulnerable to magic spells in spirit form as you are in the physical world, so add that to the list of things you have to worry about. Before I conclude, I have a few interesting side notes. Now, in terms of location, the astral plane borders several other dimensions in Marvel Comics, such as Celestial Heliopolis, the realm of the Egyptian gods, Orun, the realm of the Orishas or the West African gods, and the Dream Dimension, where the psychic entity known as Nightmare resides. Now, Nightmare, who you may or may not know, is an important part of the Doctor Strange mythos, as he is a recurring villain for the Good Doctor. He is also stated to be appearing in the upcoming movie, Doctor Strange, The Multiverse of Madness. And no doubt there will be some more astral shenanigans, as in order to even enter the dream dimension, Doctor Strange has been known to frequently use the astral planes as a sort of go-between. And that, my friend, is everything you need to know about the astral plane in accordance to the marvelous mythology of Marvel. I hope this video proves useful to you, as I know it can be, especially with the emergence of things like New Mutants, Doctor Strange 2, and the Loki miniseries, where the astral plane is bound to appear. Don't forget to like and, most important of all, subscribe to my channel. Turn on the notification bell to get notified of my next video release. Also, please leave some feedback through the comment section. And if for whatever reason the comment section is unavailable, there's a link to Reddit in the description where you can comment. Any feedback is good feedback, guys, and with that said, this has been Everdream. Thank you, and see you guys later.